and to delve into that text and discuss a certain theme that evening. It is a space for conversation and discussion. In the months between July and December, we're looking specifically at histories, at how do we document histories, where are the archives, and what are the forms of archival. In that context, we have Rumi Harish with us today, who is a trans rights activist, a researcher, writer, and a Hindustani classical musician with over 35 years of practice, who will be sharing with us excerpts from three of his scripts, and I will let him explain the context of those to us. And yeah, over to you.
Thanks. Kindly don't bother to clap in between. We will just talk. And I'm just going to present, I've written only three scripts. I'll present those excerpts of three scripts, which has come through a certain process of talking to people, different kinds of people, and then trying to creatively put something out there. My first effort in this direction was in my childhood when I was learning Hindustani classical music under Pandit Ramarao Naik in Bangalore. His training was very different, and I had the luck to unlearn under him in a very different manner because I couldn't pay fees, so I used to not have the hobby class type of class. I used to be in his house and just be around, learn, basically learn to sit and listen to a lot of music which he used to teach other students, and then my turn might come, might not come, but I learned. And the best thing that I got was to sit in his own practice, and where I would just sit playing Tanpura with him. And then that's when he used to sit and talk to us, like while singing he would talk, he would share things and all that. One thing he told us was that ragas are like human beings. They're like friends. If you don't befriend them, they will go run away. They will go far away. They'll never talk to you. They'll never be your friends. You should fall in love with ragas. They're like human beings. Some are very interesting. Some are quite boring. Some are, you know, fat. Some are thin. Some are, some have beautiful eyes. No, literally, he explained or shared about ragas in this manner, and I was very intrigued and I thought he was foolish. Growing up later, I realized that how his imagination was actually true. And then the more and more you start singing a raga, the more and more you start visualizing, or the imagination grows wild, and which was true because after his death, on his birth centenary, I wanted to write a play. Produce a play where we carry the same idea. And so I started 3 years before that, I think, or 4 years before that, I started writing something, and I was thinking I'm mad by doing this. But then thankfully, Mangai, the theater director, took it up very seriously and then helped me to produce that play on his birth centenary, which is 29th September 2009. So he was born in 1909, 9th September, 29th September 1909. So, and to do that work, I went around talking to different musicians, a lot of musicians, my own friends, different teachers, different ustads, and pandits and vidwans, and took interesting stories of Ragyaman. This is based on Ragyaman's life. And then actually started looking at the history, started talking to people, figuring out how the raga is old or enough. So I'll stop talking now. I'll read my play. It's in Kannada. I hope you understand Kannada. I can't write in English. I'm quite bad in English.
आज जाने की
जिद न करो आज जाने की जिद न करो यूं ही पहलू में बैठे रहो हाय मर जाएंगे हम तो लुट जाएंगे ऐसी बातें क्या ना करो है आज जाने की जिद ना करो
होग बेड़ा ಇವತ್ತೊಂದು ದಿವಸ ನೀವೂ ಹೋಗಬೇಡಿ ನಾನು ಮನಸ್ಸು ಬಿಚ್ಚಿ ಮಾತಾಡಬೇಕು ಮಾತಾಡಿ 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 ಹಗುರ ಆಗಬೇಕು
ವಕ್ತ ಕಿ ಕೈದ್ ಮೇ ಜಿಂದಗಿ ಹೇ ಮಗರ್ ಚಂದ ಘಡಿಯಾ ಯಹಿ ಹೇ ಜೋ ಆಜಾದ್ ಹೇ
ಕಾಲದ ಹಿಡಿತದಿಂದ ಆಚೆಗೆ ಸಿಗುತ್ತಿರುವ ಈ ಕೆಲವು ಕ್ಷಣಗಳು ನಿಮ್ಮೊಡನೆ ಕಳೆಯಬೇಕೆಂದಿದೆ ಕಾಲ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೋದ ನೆನಪುಗಳು ಗಾಥೆಗಳಾಗಿವೆ ಜೀವಮಾನಗಳಷ್ಟು ನೆನಪು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮುಂದೆ ಇಡಬೇಕು ಅನಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ನಿಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಹೋಗಬೇಡಿ ಹೆತ್ತ ಬೆಂಕಿ ಹೊತ್ತ ಕತೆಗಳ ರಂಗೋಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮುಂದೆ ಹಾಕಬೇಕು ಸುಮಾರು 800-900 ವರ್ಷಗಳ ಕಥೆ ಅಲ್ಲ ನನ್ನ ಜೀವನ ಈಗ ನನಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ವಯಸ್ಸಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂತಲೇ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಶತಮಾನಗಳಿಂದ ಬದುಕ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ನಾನು ನನ್ನ ಹರಿಯ ಬಿಟ್ಟಾಗ ಇಷ್ಟೇ ವಯಸ್ಸು ಅಂತ ನಿಖರವಾಗಿ ಹೇಳೋಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಇವತ್ತು ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ ಕನ್ನಡಿಲಿ ನೋಡಿಕೊಂಡಾಗ ಹಣ್ಣು ಮುದುಕಿ ಹಂಗೆ ಕಂಡೆ ಮುಖವೆಲ್ಲ ಸುಕ್ಕು ಕಣ್ಣು ಗುಡ್ಡೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಹೂವು ಕಣ್ಣು ಮುಚ್ಚಿ ನಿಟ್ಟುಸಿರು ಬಿಟ್ಟೆ ಒಂದೇ ಕ್ಷಣ ಸ್ಪಷ್ಟವಾಗಿ ಕಾಣುವ ದೃಷ್ಟಿ ಮುಖದಲ್ಲಿನ ಸುಕ್ಕುಗಳು ಮಾಯ ನನ್ನ ಬದುಕೆ ವಿಚಿತ್ರಪ್ಪ ಕ್ಷಣ ಕ್ಷಣಕ್ಕೂ ಬದಲಾಗ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತೀನಿ ಒಬ್ಬರ ದನಿಯಿಂದ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬರ ಮನಸ್ಸಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಬದುಕ್ತೀನಿ ಕೈ ಬೆರಳುಗಳ ಸ್ಪರ್ಶದಿಂದ ರಂಗು ಬದಲಾಗ್ತಾ ಯೌವನ ಪಡಿತೀನಿ ತಾಳಗಳ ಲೆಕ್ಕಾಚಾರಕ್ಕೆ ಕುಣಿಯುತ್ತಾ ಕುಣಿಯುತ್ತಾ ಗಡಸು ದನಿಯ ಹೆಂಗಸಾಗ್ತೀನಿ ಮೃದು ರೇಷ್ಮೆ ಶ್ರುತಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಜ್ಞಾನವಂತ ಮುದುಕಿಯಾಗ್ತೀನಿ ಆ ವಯಸ್ಸಾದ ಮುದುಕನ ಶಹನಾಯಿಯ ಉಸಿರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಮಧ್ಯ ವಯಸ್ಕ ಪಕ್ಕ ಗಂಡಸಿನಂತೆ ನಡೀತೀನಿ ಗಂಧರ್ವನ ಗಾಂಧಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಹುಡುಗಿಯರನ್ನು ಛೇಡಿಸುವ ಯುವಕನಾಗ್ತೀನಿ ನಾನು ಯಾರು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತೀರಾ ನಾನೊಂದು ರಾಗ ಒಂದು ಅನುಭವ ಧ್ವನಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಯೋಚನೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಬದುಕುವ ಆಕಾರ ಮಧ್ಯಕಾಲೀನ ಗ್ರೀಕರು ನನ್ನ ಹೈಪಾಲಿಡಿಯನ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೆದ್ರು ಪ್ರಾಚೀನ ಪರ್ಷಿಯನ್ನರು ಮಕಾಮೆ ಇಶ್ವಾಹನ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೆದ್ರು ಅರಬ್ಬಿ ಸಂಗೀತದಲ್ಲಿ ಏಮನ್ ತಮಿಳು ಸಂಗೀತದಲ್ಲಿ ಅರುಂಪಾಲೆ ಪಣ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೆದ್ರು ಈ ನೆಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಯಮನ್ ಕಲ್ಯಾಣಿ ಯಮುನಾ ಕಲ್ಯಾಣಿ ಹೀಗೆ ಹೆಸರು ಅಂದರೆ ನನಗೆ ಇಷ್ಟ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೆಸರುಗಳಿವೆ ನನ್ನ ಹುಟ್ಟಿನ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಒಬ್ಬೊಬ್ಬರು ಒಂಥರ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಪರ್ಷ್ಯಾದ ಸಾಂಪ್ರದಾಯಿಕ ಸಂಗೀತದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಮೊದಲು ಉಸಿರು ಕಂಡಿದ್ದು ಅಂತಾರೆ ಮಧ್ಯಕಾಲೀನ ಗ್ರೀಕರ ಕಾಲದಿಂದಲೂ ಬದುಕಿದ್ದೋದು ಅಂತಾರೆ ಈ ದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಅನಾದಿ ಕಾಲದಿಂದ ನಿರಾಶ್ರಿತ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜೀವನದ ತೀವ್ರತೆಗಳನ್ನು ಕಂಡಿದ್ದೂ ಇದೆ ಮೂಲ ಹೇಳ ಹೊರಟರೆ ನಾನ್ಯಾರು ನನ್ನ ಹೆತ್ತವ್ರು ಯಾರು ಯಾರ ಯೋಚನೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರ ಉಸಿರಲ್ಲಿ ಹುಟ್ಟಿದ್ದು
ನಾನು ಒಂದು ರೀತಿ ಲಾವಾರಿಸ್. ಹಾಗೆ ನೋಡಿದರೆ ನಾನು ಒಬ್ರು ಹುಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಲ್ಲ, ಅನೇಕ ಮನಸ್ಸುಗಳು ಬಿಡಿ ಅನೇಕ ಮನಸ್ಸುಗಳ ಬಿಡಿ ಯೋಚನೆಗಳಿಂದ ಬೆಳೆಯುತ್ತಾ ಬಂದಿರಬಹುದು. ಎಲ್ಲೆಡೆ ಒಂದೇ ಸಮಯಕ್ಕೆ ಪಸರಿಸಿದ್ದು ಇರಬಹುದು. ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಾಂತದಿಂದ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಪ್ರಾಂತಕ್ಕೆ ಅಲೆಮಾರಿ ಪಾದಗಳ ಬಿರುಕುಗಳಿಂದ ನಿಂತಲ್ಲಿ ಬೇರು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅನೇಕ ರೂಪಗಳು ಪಡೆದಿರಬಹುದು. ಪಯಣ ಕರೆದೈದೊಡೆ ಹೋಗುತ್ತಾ ಉಸಿರುಗಳ ಜೊತೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಗಳನ್ನು ಬೆಳೆಸಿ ಬೆಚ್ಚಗೆ ಮನೆ ಮಾಡಿ ನಿರಾಶ್ರಿತಳು ಆಗಿರಬಹುದು. ದನಿ ಕಂಡ ನೋಟಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ರೂಪ ಪಡೆಯುತ್ತಾ ಝರಿಯಂತೆ ಹರಿಯುತ್ತಾ ಋತುಗಳು ವರ್ಷಗಳು ಶತಮಾನಗಳನ್ನು ಕಾಣುತ್ತಾ ಈಗಲೇ ಈಗ ಹುಟ್ಟಿದಂತೆ ಉಳಿದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಕಲ್ಪಿಸಿಕೊಂಡವರ ಯೋಚನೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಆಕಾರ ಪಡೆದು ಶತಮಾನಗಳ ಬದುಕು ಕ್ಷಣಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಕಳೆದಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ದೆನ್ ಐ ಗೆಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ದ ರಾಗಾ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಗೆಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಅ ಲಿಟ್ಲ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್. And I'll read a little more in terms of how the raga tries to describe itself. It's a kind of rendition. So chhap tilak sab chini re musena na milai ke ಛಾಪ್ ತಿಲಕ್ ಛ ಸಬ್ ಚೀನಿ ರೆ ಮೋಸೆ ನೆನಾ ಮಿಲಾಯ್ಕೆ ನೆನಾ ಮಿಲಾಯ್ಕೆ ಮೋಸೆ ಸೇನಾ ಲಡಾಯ್ಕೆ ಮತ್ವಾರಿ ಕರ್ ದೀನಿ ರೆ ಮೋಸೆ ನೆನಾ ಮಿಲಾಯ್ಕೆ. ಸುಮಾರು 12ನೇ ಶತಮಾನ, ದಿಲ್ಲಿ ಸುಲ್ತಾನರ ಸಮಯ, ಧರ್ಮಗಳ ಹೆಸರುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಳಗಗಳಾಗುತ್ತಿದ್ದ ಕಾಲ, ಯುದ್ಧ ಹಿಂಸೆ ಪ್ರಭುತ್ವದ ರೂಪದಲ್ಲಿ ಧರ್ಮದ ಹೆಸರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ವಾರ್ಥದ ಹಸಿವಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇಡೀ ದೇಶವನ್ನು ಆವರಿಸಿತ್ತು. ಬಂಡಾಯಿಗಳು ಪ್ರೀತಿ ಪ್ರೇಮದ ಉಸಿರಾಗಿ ಏಳುತ್ತಲೇ ಇದ್ದುವು. ಧರ್ಮ ಜಾತಿ ಯುದ್ಧ ಇದು ನನ್ನ ಜಾಗೀರು, ಇದು ನಾನು ಗೆದ್ದ ಪ್ರಾಂತ, ಕಣ್ಣಿಗೆ ಕಾಣುವಷ್ಟು ಭೂಮಿ, ಭೂಮಿಯ ಒಡೆತನ, ಇಂಥ ಪುರುಷಾರ್ಥಗಳಿಂದ ದೂರ ಉಳಿದು ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯ ಜನರ ಜೀವನಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೀತಿ ಪ್ರೇಮ ಭರವಸೆಯಾಗಿ ನನಗೆ ಮೊದಲು ಅಸ್ತಿತ್ವ ಕೊಟ್ಟದ್ದು ಆ ಹುಚ್ಚು ಪ್ರೇಮಿ ಖುಸ್ರು. ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಹುಟ್ಟಿ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಬೆಳೆದು ಪ್ರಕಾಂಡ ಪಾಂಡಿತ್ಯವನ್ನು ಪಡೆದು ಕಡೆಗೆ ನಿಜಾಮುದ್ದೀನ್ ಔಲಿಯಾನ ಪ್ರೇಮ ತೆಕ್ಕೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿದ್ದಾಗ ಎಲ್ಲವನ್ನೂ ತಿರಸ್ಕರಿಸಿ ಪ್ರೇಮ ಒಂದೇ ನೋವಿನ ಔಷಧಿ ಎಂಬಂತೆ ಹುಡುಗಿ ತನ್ನ ಪ್ರಿಯತಮನಿಗಾಗಿ ಸಿಂಗರಿಸಿಕೊಂಡು ಪ್ರಿಯತಮನ ಕಣ್ಣಲ್ಲಿ ಕಣ್ಣಿಟ್ಟು ನೋಡುವಾಗ ತನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಸೌಂದರ್ಯವನ್ನು ಮರೆತ ಕ್ಷಣವಾಗಿ ನನ್ನನ್ನು ರೂಪಿಸಿದ ಖುಸ್ರು. ಛಾಪ್ ತಿಲಕ್ ಸಬ್ ಚೀನಿ ರೆ ಮೋಸೆ ನೆನಾ ಮಿಲಾಯ್ಕೆ ಛಾಪ್ ತಿಲಕ್ ಸಬ್ ಚೀನಿ. ಮುಗ್ಧ ಹುಡುಗಿಯ ಪ್ರೇಮದ ವಿಸ್ಮಯವಾಗಿ ನನ್ನನ್ನು ನಾನು ಪಡೆದೆ. ಪ್ರೇಮದ ಸ್ಪರ್ಶ ನನ್ನ ದೇಹವೇ ಆಯ್ತೇನು. ನನ್ನ ಮೊಟಕು ಕೂದಲು ಮಧ್ಯಮ ತೀವ್ರ ಮರೆ ಮಗ ಕಣ್ಣಾಲಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಅರಳುವ ಗಾಂಧಾರ ಮಗ ರೆ ಸನೆದ ನಿರೆಗ ನಿರ್ಮಾರೆ ಗಾರೆ ಮಮ ಗಾ
ಒರಟು ಕಂಬಳಿಯ ಬೆಚ್ಚಗಿನ ಗಾಂಧಾರ. ಮಮ ಗರೆ ಗ ಮ ಪದ ಪ ಮ ಗರೆ ಗ ರೆ ಸ ನಿ ಧ ನಿ ರೆ ನಿ ಧ ನಿ ರೆ ಗ. ಬೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ನಿಲ್ಲುವ ಷಡ್ಜದ ಚಡಪಡಿಕೆಯನ್ನು ನೀಗಿಸುವ ಗಾಂಧಾರ. ನೀ ಸ ನೇ ಸ ರೆ ನೇ ನೇ ಸ ಸಾರೆ ನೇ ನೇ ಗ. ಒಮ್ಮೊಮ್ಮೆ ಪಂಚಮದಿಂದ ಋಷಭಕ್ಕೆ ಜಾರುವುದು ಎವೆಯಲ್ಲೇ ಕಾದು ತಟಕ್ ಅಂತ ಬೀಳೋ ಕಣ್ಣೀರಿನಂತೆ. ಒಮ್ಮೊಮ್ಮೆ ನಿಶ್ಚಿಂತ ಹಿಂದೆ ಯಾರೋ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಎನ್ನುವ ಭರವಸೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹಿಂದಕ್ಕೆ ಬಾಗಿ ಬೀಳುವಂತೆ ಷಡ್ಜದ ತೆಕ್ಕೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬೀಳುತ್ತದೆ. ಪಾರೆ ಸಸನಿ ಅಪರಿಚಿತ ರೋಮಾಂಚನವೊಂದು ದೇಹವನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಆವರಿಸಿ ಕಳೆಯುವ ನಿಟ್ಟುಸಿರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಷಡ್ಜದ ಪ್ರಶಾಂತತೆ ಅಡಗಿದೆ.
ಸಸನಿ ಧ ನಿ ನೀರೆ ಸಾ.
I'll just stop here and read another part. Oh shit, now all my plays are in Canada, I don't know what to do. Okay, I'll just explain that particular part. So initially, right in the beginning, I've used that song, Aaj Jaane Ki Zidna Karo, to, and the raga starts saying, please don't go, I have stories to tell, I have, by telling these stories, I become youthful. And it says, suddenly it says that I don't know what my age is, because I suddenly, today morning when I got up, I looked like a grand old woman where, you know, my face had wrinkles and everything. I just closed my eyes. Nishad passed me, and then I opened my eyes and found myself to be very young. And I might be living from centuries, which I don't figure out how. And then it suddenly says, do you know who I am? And then says, I am Raaga. I'm just an experience, the experience which lives as a image in the voices, traveling from voices to thoughts. And then it says, in the medieval period, the Greeks called me Hippolydian Mode, ancient Persians called me Makame Ishwahan, and then traces a little history in terms of saying that, you know, how Arabi music called Eman, and then Tamil music called it Arumpalepan, and I have been given several names, but then I have been living like a lavaris because there are no takers for me. I'm not born to one father. It actually calls itself a bastard, because you know that. So the connotation of being bastard, which is used in a very negative, I don't know for short of word I'm using bastard, but then lavaris, bastard, all those things like. I wanted to bring in the experience of sex workers because most often the biggest insult that we give to any person is to say that, are you born of one father? What does it mean? Like, we are not born to fathers, first of all, let's be very clear. We are born to women, we're born to mothers. And secondly, mothers can decide whether they are mother or father. Why does everything has to become about that fucking seed? So let's be very clear that it does not matter.
So that's why it very, in fact, it says, if you are trying, so in one line it says that if you are trying to look at the, I don't know, moola, as in the roots, yeah. If you are trying to look at the roots, and if you ask me for my parents, and if you ask in whose breath were you born, I should say I'm Lavaris, but then, and I was not born to one person. I was born in several thinking brains, it says. And then goes on to say, and I might have been suddenly be present in several areas at the same time. And then I might have traveled through the, you know, when you travel without food, you remember the, I mean, long ago, the Narmada, in Narmada Valley, when we were being taken, and we had seen the people who worked there, who were part of the struggle and all that. I had seen their foot, like the, with lots of cracks, the heel with lots of cracks. And then I kind of thought of that image and then wrote something like, I said, so the Raga says, I might be, so in the nomads who travel from one place to another place, where they're losing the sense of belonging because of various reasons. By losing it, if you kind of, and if you're traveling and the dirt that is stuck inside the cracked heel and it falls down. So the Raga says, I might be like the dirt which have fallen in one place and might have settled there for years together like a old person. So the Raga keeps on bringing these images, saying that I could be this, I could be that, I could be anything. So it keeps suggesting. And then it says, and then it talks about Amir Khusro, saying that in the 12th century when, there's one line which is, Yuddha himse prabhutva da rupa dalli, dharma da hasarali, swartha da hasvinali. Yuddha and himse is, Yuddha is war. Himse is violence. Prabhutva is the ruling, the ruling. Dharma da hasarali, in the name of religion, in the name of selfishness, in the hunger of selfishness, and while it was spread across the state, the bandayagalu preeti premada usiriyagi eluttiddu. So the revolution and the revolt was always born in the form of love and trust. And one such person was Amir Khusro, and then I was born in his thoughts, probably for the first time. That's why I sang that Chap Tilak Sab Chini, and then talked about Khusro, and he might. Then she. Then this Raga goes on to say that I was probably born at the moment where he composed this Kavali, and then says that when the girl is getting ready to look at the or to meet the beloved, and when she sees the beloved, she forgets her own beauty. Probably I was born in that moment. So I was conceptualized in that moment, kind of thing. Yeah, and then I just kind of, now this from here, when I explain that the Madhyam is like this, the Gandhar is like this and all, that's more of how people shared with me, how in terms of, like for example, it is very interesting that Pandit Dirkan Dinkar Kakini at one point of time kind of said that the Tivra Madhyam in Rag Yaman, the Ved Sang, it feels like a woman with long hair. So the as you stretch the Madhyam, it feels like the long hair types. Now these imaginations I have like caught on and written, that's it. Yeah, I'll get into the next text. Yeah, it's speaking to the audience. It speaks to the audience till the end, and it also brings in Bollywood music. Whatever film songs were there in this Yaman, At the end, I have brought in all those, some of those songs in different languages, in Tamil, in Malayalam, in Kannada, and in Hindi. I have, because I know only these languages, so I brought in those languages. there is one interesting story which I'll just read, or I'll tell because you don't know Kannada. Sorry, I don't know. So basically, there were two musicologists called, what's his name? Shit, forgot his name. One second. Venkatamaki. So Carnatic music really praises Venkatamaki and celebrates him for his the way he constructed the design for raga structures and made the Melakarta and all that. So fortunately or unfortunately, it's a very funny story that many Carnatic musicians actually told me this about the history of Yamuna Kalyani, as they call it, or Kalyani. So because the name was not getting adjusted, they called it Mecha Kalyani or Mlecha Kalyani. But at the same time, the funny thing is that there is not one person who knows Kannada in this place. Okay, fine. So if I read, you will understand. Thank you. Ee innoba Venkatamaki iddanalla avane takraru. Naan ondu melakarta anta gurtisi andre nange tumba makkalu anta. Sambandhagalu bayyovaga enagutte anta yarigu gottu. ಹೊಸದೊಂದು ಉಸಿರು ಜೀವ ತನಗೆ ತಾನೇ ಉಸಿರಿಸಿದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋಕ್ಕಾಗತ್ತಾ? ಆಯ್ತಪ್ಪ, ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಅಂತಲೇ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ. ಅದೇನೋ ಸೂತ್ರ ಅಂತ ಮಾಡಿ ಕಟಪಯಾದಿ ಸೂತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೆಸರು ಸರಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಮೇಚ ಕಲ್ಯಾಣಿ ಅಂತ ಹೆಸರಿಟ್ರು. ಸೂತ್ರನೋ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರನೋ, ನಾನು ಮ್ಲೇಚ್ಛಳು, ನಾನು ನನ್ನ ಶುದ್ಧ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತನೋ ಏನೋ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಸರಿ, ಮ್ಲೇಚ್ಛಳಾದರೆ ಏನೋ, ಇವ್ರು ಹೇಳ್ದಂಗೆ ಇವ್ರ ನನ್ನ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಯಾರು ಮ್ಲೇಚ್ಛರಾಗಿಲ್ವಲ್ಲ. ನಾನು ಮ್ಲೇಚ್ಛಳು ಅನ್ಯಳು, ನನಗೂ ಅದೇ ಬೇಕಿತ್ತು. ಹರಿಯೋದು ಅಲೆಮಾರಿತನ, ಇವ್ರು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ಅಂತ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಳಕ್ಕಾಗತ್ತಾ? ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ನಾನು ತುರುಷ್ಕರಿಗೆ ಪ್ರಿಯಳಂತೆ, ದೇಶಿಯಂತೆ, ಗೀತಾ ಪ್ರಬಂಧಗಳನ್ನು ರಚನೆ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಲಾಯಕ್ಕಿಲ್ವಂತೆ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್. ಹಿ ಈಸ್ ರಿಟನ್ ಒನ್, ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್, ತುರುಷ್ಕಾಣ ಮತಿ ಪ್ರಿಯ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಹಿ ಗೋಸ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ಸೇ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ದೇಶಿ ರಾಗ. ದೇಶಿ ಆಸ್ ಎನ್ ಆಸ್ ಅಪೋಸ್ ಟು ದ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಟೆಡ್ ಥಿಂಗ್, ದಿಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲಿ ಬಾರ್ನ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಥಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲಿ ಬಾರ್ನ್ ದೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ದೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್, ಆರ್ ಕಲ್ಚರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್, ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್. ಯಾ, ಸೊ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಸೊ and then you are very turushkana mahi ati priya is that you are very close and dear to the Muslims or Turks. So then the raga kind of starts insulting this Venkatamaki. He says that if you assume that I am I am a lover of Muslims, I'm quite happy with that, I have no issues. And then this particular musician or musicologist banned the raga. He said that it is not fit to compose Prabandha and Gita in those in this raga, and banned it for a century. And then the raga kind of says, for how many days can you keep me away from the musicians? Because musicians fall in love with me, they cannot stop composing in me. And they came back. For a century they held themselves back, but they were back again to me. So that's the language. I've actually, in the play, I'd actually used this street Tamil to kind of say that. Mlecha is untouchable.
It was also
could be. There are many things. I'm sorry, I couldn't get the print out of this. So this is an entirely different piece, and I still was very scared of identifying myself as trans person. So, also because I'd learned music and was performing music and had the name, my dead name. So I did not have the guts to call myself a trans man at that point of time because I was in the fear of losing concerts. But anyway, because I started working in the sexuality field, I worked with a lot of trans women for their crisis cases, and which is why all the musician groups immediately kept me away. And then they wouldn't, even today they don't give me concerts to sing. It's almost like 5 years that I've sung a full-fledged baithak, where I have sung ragas over ragas, but I practice on an everyday basis. That's a different deal. I love my music, but yeah, people don't like me. I don't care. It was during that time that I had forced myself with the femininity, and not that I'm too masculine now. And then we used to have this, but I was very open about having periods, pain, cramps, and then overbleeding or less bleeding. I used to have these open discussions with all the trans women about my status and all that. So then we used to have almost like a regular conversations where they would say, oh, then you should be celebrating your periods, or I wish, you know, somebody even said, you know, I've been bleeding for the last 40 days. Then I said, you must have been dead by now. So, she's like, really? If you bleed for 40 days, you'll die. I said, then how can you live my life? So, we had several conversations like this. So, based on those conversations, I kind of wrote I think it is play, but I don't know what it is. So, this is a conversation in jail where a trans man for the first time in her life has fought through the state to be put into the female cell instead of the male cell. And she meets this union leader woman who is a construction worker and starts talking to her about being woman. I'll read to some extent, I'll read. Again, if you don't understand Kannada, what will I do? Oh my God, I hate it. On stale, it is jail. Chandini, who is a trans woman, is being pulled by the jailer. In the cell, you can see five or six women they're sleeping, and it's the night time. Jailer Roja is her name. Yenama, kadigo neen hata sadsi mahilayar cellalli bande bitte. So the jailer woman is saying, so finally you fought through and then came to the women's cell. Chandni, yen sir, heeg heltira, nan heng salva. Am I not woman? Chandni asks. Jailer Roja, nadi nadi, yen nortidya akka pakka. Alla, nodidre olle avul hage kaantiya. Yen case alli jailige bande? So the jailer is asking, you look tip top and all that, but then why did you come to jail? Chandini, nanu bhikshe kelak hoguvaga extortion case nalli arrest madidru. Suddenly in Bangalore, it so happened from 2008, the police became very clever. So initially when hijras used to beg, they were being taken and put in the beggars colony, and then we would get them out. Suddenly they developed a clever brain, and then, so if you beg and if you're asking, obviously hijras, they will, you know, they are not allowed to, or it's not allowed, they won't get any other chance to work, and nobody creates those chances. And even if you create, because I had seen my own friends trying to sell vegetables in a market or trying to set up some canteen or any such thing, everything was failing because people don't come and buy. In fact, we ourselves, trans men, one trans men group, we had set up a bakery. Nobody, people won't even come and buy cigarettes. They will come, they look at our faces. We are dressed like men, no? So we are there, and the moment they listen to our voice, they're like, they look at us in a weird way. First question is, are you man or a woman? And if you, obviously we'll become slightly, you know, disturbed, and immediately they'll move away. They'll not buy anything. So this was our experience. So Suddenly police decided this coming and begging is extortion. So then extortion is criminal case, obviously non-bailable, all those problems. ನಾನು ಭಿಕ್ಷೆ ಕೇಳಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋದಾಗ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಕೇಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಅರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು. ನಮ್ಮ ಜನಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಸುಲಭವಾಗಿ ಸಿಗದೇ ಇರೋ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕೆ ಕೆಲವರು ಜನ ಹತ್ರ ಜಬರ್ದಸ್ತಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ನಾನು ತುಂಬ ವಾದ ಮಾಡಿದ್ಮೇಲೆ ನನ್ನ ಮಹಿಳೆಯರ ಸೆಲ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕಿಕ್ಕೆ ಒಪ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರು. ಸೊ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಐ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯೂಡ್ ಕ್ವೈಟ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕೋರ್ಟ್, ದೇ ಅಗ್ರೀ ಟು ಪುಟ್ ಮೀ ಇನ್ ದ ವಿಮೆನ್ ಸೆಲ್. ಜೈಲರ್ ರೋಜಾ, ಸರಿ ಸರಿ ನಡಿ ನಡಿ, ಈ ಸೆಲ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗು. ಏನೇನೋ ಅಂತ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಿರೋ, ಏನೇನಂತ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಿರೋ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನರಕ ಅನುಭವಿಸೋಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾಕೆ ಬರ್ತಿರೋ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಏನೋ ಆ ಅಲ್ಲ, ನೀವು ಮಾಡಿರೋದನ್ನು ಮಾಫ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸಾಕು. ಸೊ ದಿ ಜೈಲರ್ ರೋಜಾ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್, ಓಕೆ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಕೇರ್, ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಆಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಯು ಫಾರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡನ್. ಚಾಂದಿನಿ ತನ್ನ ಕೂದಲನ್ನು ಕಟ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಸೆಲ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಲಿಡ್ತಾಳೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಚಾಂದಿನಿ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಹೇರ್, ಐ ಮೀನ್ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲಿ ಗ್ರೋನ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಹೇರ್. ಅಲ್ಲಿ 5-6 ಮಹಿಳೆಯರು ಆಗಲೇ ಅಲ್ಲಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಅವರೆಲ್ಲ ಚಾಂದಿನಿಯನ್ನು ನೋಡಿ ಪಿಸಿ 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 ಅಂತ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಅದರ್ ವಿಮೆನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್ ಹೂ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಸ್ಪರಿಂಗ್ ಅಟ್ ದಟ್ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್. ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನಿಂದೇನು ಕೇಸು ಚಾಂದಿನಿಯಾಸ್, ನಿಂದೇನು ಕೇಸು ಟು ಒನ್ ವುಮನ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಸಿಟಿಂಗ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಡೇ. ದ ವುಮನ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್. ಅನದರ್ ವುಮನ್ ಸೇಸ್, ಓ ನೀನು ಇಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಬಂದ್ಯಾ, ಏನು ಕೇಸು? ಅನದರ್ ವುಮನ್ ಹೂ ಪ್ರಾಬಬ್ಲಿ ನೋಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಆಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕೇಸ್, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಷನ್ ಕೇಸು. ಈ ದ ಮೊಮೆಂಟ್ ಚಾಂದಿನಿ ಸೇಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಷನ್ ಕೇಸ್, ಇಮ್ಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಅದ ವುಮನ್ ಸೇಸ್, ಅಯ್ಯೋ ಇದು ಹೆಂಗಸಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ, ಇದನ್ನ ತಂದು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ದ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೇಲ್ ನೋ, ಸೊ ನಿನ್ನ ಡೀಪ್ ವಾಯ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದ ಅದರ್ ವಿಮೆನ್ ಜಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಸ್ಕೇರ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಓ ಮೈ ಗಾಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ವುಮನ್, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಪುಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹಿಜ್ರಾ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ ಸೆಲ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಚಾಂದಿನಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಇನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗರ್ ಚಾಂದಿನಿ ಸೇಸ್, ಅದು ಇದು ಅಂತ ಮಾತಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ನನ್ನ ಏನು ಅನ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ? ಸೊ ಇಟ್, ದೇ ಕಾಲ್ ಹರ್ ಇಟ್. ಸೊ ಶಿ ಸೇಸ್, ಶಿ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್, ವೈ ಆರ್ ಯು ಕಾಲಿಂಗ್ ಮೀ ಇಟ್? ಹಾಂ, ನಾನು ಹೆಂಗ್ಸೆ. ಶಿ ಸೇಸ್, ಶಿ ಕ್ಲೇಮ್ಸ್ ಈವನ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ವುಮನ್. ದ ಅದರ್ ವಿಮೆನ್, ಹೆಂಗ್ಸ್ ಅಂತೆ ಹೆಂಗ್ಸು, ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ಹೆಂಗ್ಸಾಗ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ನಾವೇನು? ಸೊ ದ ವಿಮೆನ್ ಸೇ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಬಿಕಮ್ ವಿಮೆನ್ ದೆನ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ವಿ? ದೆನ್ ಜೈಲರ್ ರೋಜಾ, ಏನು ಸದ್ದು, ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಮಲ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಸೊ ಜೈಲರ್ ರೋಜಾ ಸೇಸ್, ಕಮ್ ಆನ್ ಶಟ್ ಅಪ್, ಬಿ ಕ್ವೈಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಲೀಪ್. ದೆನ್ ಚಾಂದಿನಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹೊತ್ತು ಅಕ್ಕಪಕ್ಕ ನೋಡ್ತಾಳೆ, ಮಹಿಳೆಯರು ಪಿಸಿ ಪಿಸಿ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಆಗ ಚಾಂದಿನಿ ಮೆತ್ತಿಗೆ ಆ ಸುಮ್ಮನಿದ್ದ ಮಹಿಳೆ ಹತ್ರ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಚಾಂದಿನಿ. ಸೊ ಚಾಂದಿನಿ ಫಾರ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಶಿ ಕೀಪ್ಸ್ ಕ್ವೈಟ್, ದೆನ್ ಶಿ ಟ್ರೈಸ್ ಟು ಟಾಕ್ ಟು ದ ವುಮನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಹರ್. ಶಿ ಅಗೈನ್ ಸೇಸ್, ಹೆದರಬೇಡ, ನನ್ನ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನಿಂಗೆ ವಿಚಿತ್ರ ಅನ್ನಿಸ್ಬಹುದು. ಶಿ ಸೇಸ್, ಡೋಂಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಸ್ಕೇರ್ಡ್, ವೆನ್ ಯು ಲಿಸನ್ ಟು ಮೈ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೈಟ್ ಸೌಂಡ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್. ಬಟ್ ದಟ್ ವುಮನ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಕ್ವೈಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಯು ನೋ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಹರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಅಯ್ಯೋ ಬೀಡು, ಇದ್ದದ್ದೇ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ನಮ್ಮನ್ನು ನೋಡಿ ಹೆದರ್ತಾರೆ, ಚೀತು ಅಂತಾರೆ, ಅದು ಇದು ಅಂತಾರೆ, ದೂರ ಬಿಸಾಕ್ತಾರೆ. ನಾವು ಮನುಷ್ಯರು ಅಂತ ನೋಡಲ್ಲ, ನಾವು ಹೆಂಗಸರು ಅಂತ ನೋಡಲ್ಲ. ದೆನ್ ಶಿ ಇಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಕರ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಹರ್ ಓನ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಡೂ, ಬಟ್ ದೇ ನೆವರ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಅಸ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ದೆನ್ ಒನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್, ಐಲ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಕಿಪ್ ಅ ಲಿಟ್ಲ್. So they in the night they all go back to sleep. Suddenly it freezes there, they're all sleeping on the sides, and in the center comes the so there are two characters, one is Samaja and one is Sutradhara or Sutradhari, it could be whatever. Samaja, yoniye swahaya namaha, shishnave swahaya namaha, ಮೊಲೆಯೇ ಸ್ವಾಹಾಯ ನಮಃ, ಗಡ್ಡ ಮೀಸೇ ಸ್ವಾಹಾಯ ನಮಃ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ಮೆನ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ದಿಸ್, ಸ್ವಾಹಾಯ ನಮಃ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಯಾರು ಹೇಗೆ ಬೇಕೋ ಹೇಗಿರಬೇಕೋ ಹಾಗಿರಬೇಕು, ಇಲ್ಲಾಂದರೆ ಇದೇ ಗತಿ. ಸೊ ದ ಸಮಾಜ ಇಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಹೌ ಪೀಪಲ್, ಹೌ ಮೆನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿಮೆನ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್, ಅದರ್ವೈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಟೀರಿಯರೇಟ್.
ಗಂಡಸು ಹೆಂಗಸಾಗೋದು, ಹೆಂಗಸು ಗಂಡಸರ ವಿರುದ್ಧ ವಿದ್ರೋಹ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಅವನತಿಯ ಸಂಗೀತ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಂಕೇತ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಡಿಜನರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್. ಸಮಾಜ ಸಿಸ್ ದಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಡನ್ಲಿ ದ ಸೂತ್ರಧಾರ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೇಸ್ ಕಪ್ಪು ಬಿಳುಪು. ಸೊ ಸೂತ್ರಧಾರ ಇಸ್ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು ಲೊಕೇಟ್ ದ ಬೈನರೀಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೇಸ್ ಕಪ್ಪು ಬಿಳುಪು, ಒಣಗಿದೆಳೆಗಳು, black and white and the dried leaves. Odeyada molakegalu and the blossoms which have not yet blossomed. Lingatvada antaragalu, the distances within gender. Manadandagalu oppige nirakaranegalu, the measurements and then the acceptance and rejections. Vyakhyana vivaragalu, definitions and debates. Preeti, prema, vishwasagala, kaanke, torikegalu, adu samaja nirmita. So love, trust, the showing of love and trust and the pretense, even that is constructed by the society. ಶಾಸನ ಕಟ್ಟಳಲೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಅರ್ಧಮಾಗಿರುವ ಹಸಿ ಗಾಯಗಳು, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಎಡಿಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ರೂಲ್, ವಿ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ವೂನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಆರ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಹಾಫ್ ಹೀಲ್ಡ್. ಹುಚ್ಚು ಮನಸ್ಸುಗಳು ನಗುತ್ತಲೇ ವಹಿಸಬೇಕಾದ ಪಾತ್ರಗಳು, ದ ಮ್ಯಾಡ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ರನ್ ಇನ್ ಯೋರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ the roles that we have to live smiling in the society. Patragala begudi and the deep down boiling feeling inside of each role that we kind of play in public or inside at home. ಇದೆಲ್ಲದರ ಮಧ್ಯೆ ಅಸ್ತಿತ್ವಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾರಣಗಳನ್ನು ಹುಡುಕಿ ಎಲ್ಲರ ಒಪ್ಪಿಗೆ ಪಡೆದೇ ಬದುಕುವುದು, ಅದೇ ವಾಸ್ತವ. ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ಲಿ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರೂತ್ ಅಮಿಡ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್? ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಎಂಡ್ ಅಪ್ ಫೈನಲಿ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಬೈ ವಾಟ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಸೇಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗೋ ಬೈ ವಾಟ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಎಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲಿವ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡೈ ಇನ್ ದಟ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ರಿಯಾಲಿಟಿ. ಈ ವಾಸ್ತವಕ್ಕೆ ಕನಸು ಕಾಣಲು ರೆಕ್ಕೆಗಳಿಲ್ಲ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ರಿಯಾಲಿಟಿ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ವಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಡ್ರೀಮ್. ಅಪೂರ್ಣ ಪೂರ್ಣ ಜೀವಗಳು ಒಪ್ಪಿಗೆ ನಿರಾಕರಣೆಗಳ ಮೇಲೆ ನಿಂತಿವೆ. ದ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ನೆಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಅಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರಿಜೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ಬದುಕಲು ಬದುಕಿಗೆ ಬದುಕು ಎಂದು ಹೆಸರಿಟ್ಟವರು ಯಾರು? ಟು ಲಿವ್ ದ ಲೈಫ್, ಹೂ ನೇಮ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಲೈಫ್? ಸೊ ದ ಅಗೇನ್ ದ ಸೂತ್ರಧಾರ ದೆನ್ ದೇ ಮೂವ್ ಅವೇ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಜೈಲ ರೋಜ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್. ದೆನ್ ಸೆಲ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಇನ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ಗೆಟ್ ಅಪ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ದೇ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್. ಎಲ್ರೂ ಹೇಳ್ರಮ್ಮ ಹೇಳಿ ಹೇಳಿ. ಸೊ ದೇ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್. ದ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಯಲ್ ಕಾನ್ವರ್ಸೇಷನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ವುಮನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ವುಮನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಚಾಂದಿನಿ, ನಿನ್ನ ಹೆಸರೇನು? ಶಿ ಸೇಸ್ ದ ಹಿಜ್ರಾ ಆಸ್ ದ ವುಮನ್ ವಾಟ್ಸ್ ಯರ್ ನೇಮ್. ದ ವುಮನ್ ಸೇಸ್ ಮಲ್ಲಿ. ಯಾವ ಊರು ನಿಂದು? ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್? ಶಿ ಸೇಸ್ ದ ವುಮನ್ ಸೇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ನಿನ್ನೊಂದು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಕೇಳಬಹುದಾ? ಹಿಜ್ರಾ ಆಸ್, ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಐ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಯು ಎ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್? ದನ್ ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಸೀರಿಯಸ್ ಆಗಿ, ಹಾಂ, ನಿನ್ಗೆ ಮದುವೆ ಆಗಿದೆಯಾ? ಹಿಜ್ರಾ ಆಸ್ ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಐ ಯು ಮ್ಯಾರಿಡ್. ದೆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವುಮನ್ ಸೇಸ್ ನೋ. ಯಾಕೆ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿಲ್ಲ? ಇಮ್ಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಹಿಜ್ರಾ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ವೈ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ಂಟ್ ಯು ಮ್ಯಾರಿಡ್? ಮಹಿಳೆ ಒಮ್ಮೆ ಮುಖ ದುರುಗುಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ನೋಡ್ತಾಳೆ, ಉತ್ತರಿಸುವ ಹೊತ್ತಿಗೆ ರೋಜಾ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾಳೆ. ಸೊ ಬೈ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಶಿ ಆನ್ಸರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಜೈಲರ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್, ಸೊ ಶಿ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಕೀಪ್ಸ್ ಕ್ವೈಟ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೆನ್ ದೆನ್ ಜೈಲರ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀಮ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಕೀಪ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್, ಡೋಂಟ್ ಟಾಕ್ ಇನ್ ಆಲ್ ದಟ್. ದೆನ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ದೇ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್. ಒನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್.
Channi says, yak markondilla, suddenly. She's like, yenu, what? Why have you not? She just says, why have you not done? And this woman suddenly thinks, what? Madhve, marriage. Hengsu and kudle madhve madkolbeku ante enadru idya? So the woman says, just because I'm woman, is there something that I have to be married? Then this hijra gets a little concerned. She's like, yak hang heltiya? Like as though, you know, there's something wrong with this woman. Malli. Nodavrella kelod adu munde eno dodda vishaya anno thara. So everybody who sees me asks the first question, are you married? And if I say no, the only thing that they're concerned about is my marriage. Channi says, ayyo, idenanno maatu, naan hengsakokke eshtu kashtapattidini, chick vayasu ninda nange iddu kanasu, hengsagi olle gandan jothe olle mantanadalli madve maadkondu, ganda mane makkalu ant irbeku, bhimnavasya divasa gandange paada pooje maadi, ellar manegalige arshina kunkumakke hogi, muttaideyagi, she goes on in a line saying, from my childhood, I dreamt to become a woman and I wanted to wash the feet of my husband, do the Bhimnavamase thing and, you know, worship my husband and live with lots of children. She goes on in online and then Malli says, Ma, yake, yenaito, nanendu tap heladna. The Hijra says, have I said something wrong? Then Malli says, illa hagala, no, not like that. Then Channi, then mate, then again, Roja, so again then Roja comes and disturbs and all that. Then again she continues, Ale yak hag helde nino? Why did you say that? Then Malli, hore ansate. What? Nothing. Hore ansate. It feels like burden. Hengsa girodu hore ansata ninge. Ningen gotu abhagya. So basically it says that you feel a burden being a woman. What do you understand the luck of being woman? What do you understand the charm of being woman? Then Malli goes on, bhagya ante bhagya, eshton kelsa madbeko, amma maglu hengti kelsa madoru mane gauru amutta ide abba ishtella mado hengsrige award kodbeko. So Malli screams back at her saying, you have to play the role of mother, sister, daughter, be obedient and then do work inside house, outside house, and in fact for all this women should be given award. Malli says that. Channi, hengasarige sahajavagi barodanna neen hore andre hege, neen helodu atti ansalva. Women is naturally made to do all these things. Don't you think that you are saying too much? So this whole conversation goes like this. So I've developed that whole thing. That is my second script. If you have any questions, otherwise I'll just read one small bit from Freedom Begum and then we'll get into discussions. Is this fine?
How many do you think in Bangalore?
What category? Say that. There's nothing wrong in saying it. Yes, we don't know. We haven't counted. And I don't think numbers matter. Now, first of all, you need to understand that being transgender doesn't mean only male to female. There are female to male also. There are people, see, if you look at gender as a journey, the journey need not be just between male and female. The society has constructed this binary of male and female. Unfortunately, we have not even thought of any other expression possible. Like, for example, if you take my own case, I always wanted to be a man with beard, without penis. I hate penis. I cannot stand a penis. I cannot think of penis. The very, you know, the construct of a penis kills me. Like, I can't even think of it on my body. That much of phobia I have towards penis. But I want to be a man. Like, that can also be a gender. What is wrong in
Can there not be people without penis? Men who without penis? Like, I really wanted to, you know, I mean, my next thing that I'm thinking of is actually, there are two things that I want to write. One is that to say that, you know, vagina man, notes from a vagina man is what I really want to write. Because gender, see, the question is not about the dysphoria that we have. The question is more about what we want to be. It's not the dysphoria, because the question is not about the being born in a wrong body. I'm not born in a wrong body. It's not even other. I want to correct my body. Like how, if a haircut goes wrong, won't you go back to the barber and get it corrected? Similarly, I want to rechange my body because it's not suiting me. No, that is, what is wrong in it? That is also, huh? No, because I didn't think of writing about trans men at that point of time. My whole thing at that point of time was to write about, see, there was huge debates going about who is a woman. The woman who carries a womb is woman. The woman who does this is a woman. So there were identities and markers about who is a woman, who is a man types. So that's why these two characters actually in my script come and start exploring and talking and bring the entire discourse of gender to say that even you in that t-shirt with that mush and with that hair, whatever you feel, if you feel you are a woman, you are a woman. That's it. That's all matters. All the other markers, identities, roles, responsibilities, and the work, associations, all these associations are just associations which are created by the patriarchal Brahminical society to fix a certain role to that particular gender. So I wanted to bring out that entire discourse to be spoken simply, because in academic circles, you always speak in big language. But when you have to talk to a ground level, I mean, I thought of this play to be staged on streets so that people understand this language. It was not meant for academic circles. Okay, so me and my friend Sunil, with whom I've been working for the last 16 years, I worked before him also, but after he came, there was a marked difference in our work. We started focusing only on crisis intervention of the queer and trans community. One thing that we have always felt is that gender is actually by mistake used as an identity. Gender is actually an expression which everybody goes through. It's like, you express your gender in this way, and you do in that way. Now, I look at you, and then I try to mark you as he or she. But you have to decide whether you are he or she. Now, this he or she becomes the gender marker. But if I just look at you, and I understand this as a particular expression of gender without giving it an identity, you just remove the identity part of it in the society. Why? Because caste definitely is an identity. Class is definitely an identity. Labor is an identity. Different things can become identity, but not gender. Because gender, you know, makes an unequal status for people when you make it into an identity. If you want to, then think about the reservations or the kind of positive and protective laws or protective rights that needs to come for different kinds of women. Muslim women, Dalit women, Adivasi women, women of unorganized sex labor. If you want to think of women of different, then include trans women, include gender, marginalized genders. So, you know, they all can become one set of people who will need extra protection rights.
But otherwise, in your ID, in terms of in PAN card, Aadhaar card, that card, this card, whatever card, use caste, use whatever. Religion also not so much as an identity, but then, I mean, that will become a big issue, but then, because there is a historical injustice of caste, and for which the protective rights are very much needed. Yeah, yeah, of course, of course. So, We have two judgments which has managed to give us trans people the legal citizenship rights. And there's also recently another judgment which decriminalized homosexuality. So it's all like, technically it's supposed to be accepted, but recently when I went to a police station for one of the crisis cases in Hebal police station, I think, the policeman, I was talking about this whole thing. So they said, oh, you girl-girl case, which means, oh, you have come for a girl-girl case. I said, yeah, I have come for a girl-girl case. And immediately, second question, you kidnapped the girl. I said, no, I didn't kidnap the girl. I'm the person who is representing the girl. I came with the lawyer. Then the third question is, but you have a haircut. I'm like, so what if I have a haircut? Then we both lawyer and me, both are talking about 377 and said that homosexuality is decriminalized. The police says, ah, it might have come in India. It's not in Karnataka. I know. And I mean, I don't think we should speak that here, but I'm all for a South Indian Union. Yeah, yeah, tell me. Yes. No, my entire using of theater or using of writing, using of music also to a large extent is to simplify this academic language, because I also get bored and I want to run away from this language. And, you know, especially when they say something like, I recently received my trans certificate, which says, you know, a patient of gender dysphoria. I sat and laughed half an hour sitting there. Like, what gender dysphoria? Fucking I know what gender I belong to. I'm a psychiatrist. Psychiatrist has to issue that to me. I'm like 15 years, I know my life. What are you trying to tell me? Yeah, tell me. She has a question. Psychiatrist. Yeah, whatever. So let me move into another. Woman. See, the thing is that what I realized is that in the trans lives, in order to get validation that I'm woman or I'm man kind of thing. In the 20 years ago, there were nobody like really thinking of saying that I'm gender neutral and like having a full beard and crop and then still wear a sari and walk around in public. That was very, very uncommon and, you know, at that point of time when one new wave of feminists like us had walked in and then where we were vocal about our body processes and all that. These trans women actually, their concept of, I had spoken to many people and their concept of being woman was like the Sharapanjara Kalpana, if you know Kannada cinema and if you understand the woman there who is all sacrificing, always like, types. And then, you know, which literally many of the trans women would repeat and then, you know, at one level it is extremely, they used to actually critique it in a satirical manner, but at the same time would also dreamt of, you know, and then some of them even said that I actually get up and, you know, instead of thali, whatever that they are wearing, they actually touch that, kiss that and do the, touching the leg of their partners, which are not husbands. So, you know, this fascination, imagination of being woman is associated with the construct of being woman. But actually, what is being woman? That is the two things that I juxtaposed in that play. I didn't get you? The last part I didn't get. So it was, I wrote it long back. Maybe now if I rewrite it, I think I'll take it to a space where I would say that everybody should define gender for themselves. I, at that point of time, let me tell you what I did. I just switched off. I kind of have forgotten. I think I wrote it in 2010 or 11. I just decided to express my transition gender only 5 years ago. Before that, I was this obedient woman.
What was the reason? Were you psychologically too scared to declare yourself?
No, I was this established musician, no.
No.
I won't get chances if I'm not a woman. It's about losing identity as a musician. The music circle, no, is so, actually, see, that is the worst thing in music circle. If you don't, on a concert platform, if you don't wear a pattu sari, keep the big bindi, have long hair, and if you don't, and you know, the gold bangles, all that fuck all shit, and go sit with the tanpura. Like if I'm like this and if I go and sit with the tanpura, they'll not entertain. Even the accompanying artist will look at me like this. So if I wanted to continue being a commercial performer, I wouldn't have gotten concerts at all. I mean, I didn't get concerts in the last 6-7 years. Because I started breaking that dress sense first. Then I started wearing jeans pant, kurtas, jeans pant, shirts for classical concerts. Then it stopped. No, of course not. They fought with me, I fought with them. Now they're in talking terms, I'm in talking terms. But one very plus point about my parents was they're never violent. We'll have arguments, we'll cry, we will talk. And my mother seems to be like one of those fantastic human beings because I think she also had a lot of gender struggles. I should be telling now. I'm sorry, I generally don't use her name. She is the only woman sculptor in India who does traditional temple sculptures in huge sizes in granite stones. Her name is Kanaka Murthy. So that's how I am. I crossed my gender battles much earlier, and there's caste battles that I had to cross, because we belong to Brahmin family where it is very chichi to work with parakarmikas, chichi to work with transgenders, and chichi to work with sex workers. And that is the first work I got into. No, my mother easily, she understood, but her thing was like, yeah, society. So it ends with both people. Now I remember. Sorry. So this Malli, the woman, was also this actually one of the leading Dalit activist who at one point of time had joined the Naxal movement. And then she was traumatized by the Naxal leaders because she was Dalit, and she would never come in the high rank orders in Naxal movement. And then when she was jailed, she was, they literally put sand in her vagina and then traumatized Andhra. It's actually Warangal. If I reveal more, you will know. So I can't. So story had literally, and the way she talks about her being a woman and the way she conducts herself was really fabulous. You know, she's something amazing. That is the character I kind of brought into this, the Malli woman in the jail. And then, so both of them share their stories, and then finally come to a conclusion saying that, but this is how we negotiate our genders. Yeah. Can I read the other one or? Yeah. Now this is slightly weird. It is in 6 languages. Please, I can't translate. If somebody can please help. But I'm sure you will be able to understand. This is not difficult. Excuse me, can you tell me where the Nachia restaurant is here, please? Manje malum nahi, na gotila. Madam, Begum Mahal bus stop, udhar, ask there, heltare. Begum Mahal bus stop, where is it? What is Begum Mahal? Wo hamara Begum, hum sab ka mahal, big, very, very big. Freedom theater hi nahi. उसके चोनर अब नहीं क्या भी नहीं खाली बस स्टॉप. This seems to be really interesting. I need to go in search of this Freedom Begum. Sir, can you tell me more about your Begum? Was there a mahal here? How is it your mahal? Begum tumba badi aurat bejaan paisa wo it sab ko dekhti tanga wala auto wala raddi wala nachne wala hum sab ko dekhti. ತುಂಬಾ ಕಾರ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಮಹಲ್ ನಮ್ದುಕೆ ಮಹಲ್ ಯಾರು ಯಾವಾಗ ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೂ ಹೋಗ್ಬೋದು ಬೇಗಂ ಮಹಲ್ ಬಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಉಧರ್ ಜಾವ್ ಜಾವ್ ದರ್ಸ್ ಅ ಸಡನ್ ಗ್ರಿಪ್ ಫಿಯರ್ ದಟ್ ಗ್ರಿಪ್ಸ್ ದ ಸಡನ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಕಟ್ ವೈಲ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಟು ಟೆಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಕಟ್ ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸ್ಟೋರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಏರಿಯಾ ಫಾರ್ ಬೇಗಂ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಹೌ ಪೀಪಲ್ ವುಡ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು telling stories, and suddenly the fear grips and they will control themselves, and then suddenly shoo us away. So initially the shooing away had happened, and we had to go befriend all these people again and again, again and again, for them to tell us the stories. So then,
So there's a mad person who screams, "Hey, shoo, hogache! Yen apshakna nino? Jatra bere shuriyagide. Ellaru tayariyalli idare. Neen bere illi. Illi yake bande? Hogache." Benki, neeru. Benki, neeru, benki, neeru. Benki urisutte, neeru tanisutte. Benki urisutte, neeru tanisutte. Tanisutte, urisutte, tanisutte, urisutte. Ikade benki, akade neeru. ಈ ಕಡೆ ಬೆಂಕಿ ಆ ಕಡೆ ಕೆರೆ. ಕೆರೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಸಮತೆ. ಸಮತೆಯನ್ನು ಉಳಿಸಿ ಬಾಯರ್ಕೆಯನ್ನು ನೀಗಿಸಿ ತಂಪು ಕೊಟ್ಟು ತಂಪನ್ನು ಎರೆಯುವುದು. ಎಲ್ಲ ಸತ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ಹೊಟ್ಟೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹೊತ್ತು ಇತಿಹಾಸದ ಎಲ್ಲ ಘಟನೆಗಳಿಗೆ ಸಾಕ್ಷಿಯಾಗಿ ನಿಲ್ಲುತ್ತದೆ. ಮಾರಿಯಮ್ಮ ನಮ್ಮೂರು ದೇವತೆ, ಎಲ್ಲರನ್ನ ನಿವಾರಿಸೋಳು ಅಂದರೆ ಬೆಂಕಿಯೋಳು. ಬೆಂಕಿ ಮಧ್ಯ ಬರೋ ಶಿಷ್ಟ ದೇವರುಗಳನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಪಕ್ಕಕ್ಕೆ ತಳ್ಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಮಾರಿಯಮ್ಮ ಊರಿಗೆಲ್ಲ ಬೇಕಾಗೋ ನಂಬಿಕೆ ಹಂಚ್ತಾಳೆ, ಊಟ ಹಂಚ್ತಾಳೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿನ ನೀರು ಬೆಂಕಿ, ನಮ್ಮ ಉಸಿರು ಬೆಂಕಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನೀರು, ನೀರಲ್ಲಿ ಬೆಂಕಿ, ಉಸಿರಲ್ಲಿ ಉಸಿರು, ನೆನಪಲ್ಲಿ ಮರಳು, ಮರಳಲ್ಲಿ ನೆನಪು. ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಬೇಕು, ಎಷ್ಟು ಬೇಕು? ಸಸ್ತ ಸುಂದರ ಟಿಕಾವು ನೆನಪು, ಸಸ್ತ ಸುಂದರ ಟಿಕಾವು ಮರಳು. ಮತ್ತು ಹಾಡು ಶುರು ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಜಾತ್ರೆ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಆ ಥರ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಮತ್ತು ತಿರ್ಗಾ ಅದೇ ಕೋರಸ್ ಜನ ವಾಪಸ್ಸು ಬಂದು So the basically the person starts searching where is Freedom Mahal or Freedom Begum and what is the Mahal that they're talking about. And then, so they all speak in mixed languages. These are all street vendors and people on the streets. And then they start sharing and suddenly there's a fear and they don't open. And then suddenly there's a person who seems to have lost her sense. And that person blabbers so many things. This is what she blabbers. She talks about how in this space, in that space, there is fire and there is water. There is culture of fire and water, and how both can kill people, both can also make the people alive. And how Mariamma actually comes and gives food to all the hungry people. And in the end, she suddenly says, in the whole blabbering, she says that this is where I have brought the concept of oral history. So she says, Ilina benki niru namma usiru. The fire and water here is our breath. Benki ali niru, nirali benki. Water and fire, fire and water. Usirali usiru nenapalli marulu. There's breath in breath, and nenapu is memory, marulu is maralu, maralu sand, marulu. Marulu is marulu. Not, like forgetfulness, madness, bhrant. If you know Malayalam, it says bhrant. It's not madness exactly. So that kind of a thing. So nenapalli marulu. You do have a nenapu, the memory, and you also have this madness. And marulali nenapu. So there is, even within the madness, there is some memory. Yarig beko, yesht beko, which means these days the oral histories has become like a business. Sasta sundar tikavu nenapu, sasta sundar tikavu marulu. Because suddenly in the process of methodologies of research in history, suddenly, when it started focusing oral history, it became so important that we are all subjects of oral histories as trans people. And people come and ask us questions like, when did you realize you are trans? When did you know you are a homosexual? I mean, like, when did you know you were a heterosexual? Kindly tell me first. Question one. Question two. What? Do you know who was the first homosexual? Do you know homosexuality has some history at all? So these kind of questions will actually... Please, no issues. Okay, thank you. So, and then, you know, the ridiculous questions we have to answer. In the name of oral history, in the name of history research, and then somebody will say psychosocial nonsense, then somebody will say, what, anthropological research, whatever it is. I'm like, my God, ask sensible questions, yaar. We are, that's why I use particularly as a nenapalli marulu, marulali nenapu. Immediately say, yaar beku, yesht beku. So our community people have become so used to these questions. We have ready answers now. So everybody is ready to tell stories of sob stories. You know, everybody, even though their things are improving and things are better, and some people might not, need not undergo that kind of traumatic story, you cook up a traumatic story and tell. Otherwise, it is like, how can a trans person not be sad? Hey? You.
Huh?
No, I have seen, okay, in my own community. The worst part is, because I know actually 6 languages, fucking people take me for translations. And one particular community person, my own friend, very close friend, but I cannot reveal his name. This was the 8th time I had translated his story. 8 times, full story change. I am like looking at a face like this. What? What? Last time you said a different story. I'm like, listen. You can't do this. And then he in our own language, he's saying, shut up, you know, that's what they want. I will tell. What is your problem? You translate whatever I say types. So we are also very well. And it also depends. If they're giving more money, then we'll give more sober story. More sober story. That is also there. So, anyway. ನಾವು ಕೊಳಕ್ ಜನರು ಧಂದ ಮಾಡೋರು ಅದು ಅಲ್ಲ ಇದು ಅಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ನೋ ದೆನ್ ವೇರ್ ದ ವಿ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ ಹೌ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಟ್ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹೌ ದ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಐ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ ದಟ್ ಬಟ್ ಐ ರಿಯಲಿ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ರೀಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಒನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಗರಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಬೇಗಮ್ ವಿ ವೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ವಿ ಇಂಟರ್ವ್ಯೂಡ್ ಸೆವ್ರಲ್ ಆಟೋ ಡ್ರೈವರ್ಸ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಮುಸ್ಲಿಮ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ನಾನ್ ಮುಸ್ಲಿಮ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಸ್ಪೋಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ದಖನಿ ಉರ್ದು. This is what I'm going to read. This is actual conversation which we recorded. Auto driver. Ah, mast figure. Auto madam, auto. The researcher thinks, maybe I can ask him. Yes madam, kidhar ko jana so? Bhaiya, yaha kya chal raha hai? Ye, jatre madam, ur jatre. Kya? Jatre kya hai bhaiya? ಮೇಡಮ್ ಆ ಚಿತ್ತರ್ಕ ಪೂರ್ಣ ಮಹೀನಾ ತೊ ಜಾತ್ರೆ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಪಾಲ್ಕಿ ಒಟ್ಟಾತಾಸೋ ಖರ್ಗಾ ಹೋತಾಸೋ ನಾಚನ ಗಾನ ಸಬ್ಬಿಚ್ ಹೋತಾಸೋ ಅಚ್ಛಾ ಭಯ್ಯಾ ಮುಜೆ ಐಸೆ ಹಿ ಘೂಮ್ನಾ ಆವೋಗೆ ಐಸೆ ಹಿ ಘೂಮ್ನಾ ಆವ್ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಆವ್ ದ ಆಟೋ ಡ್ರೈವರ್ಸ್ ನೆವರ್ ಸೇ ಮ್ಯಾಡಮ್ ದೇ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಸೇ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಓಕೆ ದೆನ್ ಹಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಹರ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ the researcher says slowly says bhaiya begum mahal ke bare mein suna hai wo madam tum bhi wo ho wo kya bhaiya kya bhi nahi madam ye research pasarch karte hi na vaisech karke bol liya so ha bhaiya ye research hi hai to aapko kuch malum hai begum mahal ke bare mein auto driver madam sabbe ko ek kahani hota ಬೇಗಂ ಮಹಲ್ ಕೆ ಬಾರೇ ಮೇ ಕ್ಯಾ ಟೈಮ್ ಗಯಾ ಹಿ ನಾ ಕ್ಯಾ ಭಿ ಯಾದ ನಹಿ ಪರ್ ಸಬ್ ಲೋಗಾ ಅಪ್ನಿ ಅಪ್ನಿ ಕಹಾನಿ ಬೋಲ್ತಾ ಸೋ ಅಚ್ಛಾ ಭಯ್ಯಾ ತುಮ ಅಪ್ನಿ ಕಹಾನಿ ಬತಾವ ಮಾಂಜೆ ಕ್ಯಾ ಮಾಲೂಮ್ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಉಧರ್ ಬಹುತ್ ಖರಾಬ್ ಖರಾಬ್ ಹೇ ಕೆಲ್ಸಾ ಹೋತಾ ಸೋ ಉಸ್ಕೋ ಕ್ಯಾ ಕಹತೆ ವೋ ಧಂದಾ ಕರ್ತಿ ವೋ ಬೇಗಮ್ ಶಾದೀಚ್ ನಹಿ ಕಿ ಯ ಔರತ್ ಹಮಾರಾ ಬೇಗಮ್ ವೋ ಪಠಾನ್ ಕಿ ರಖೇಲ್ ಉಸ್ಕೋ ದೋ ಬಚ್ಚಾ ಏಕ್ ಮರ್ ಗಯಿ ಪಾಂಪ್ ಮೇನೆ ಸುನಾ ಕಿ ಬೇಗಮ್ ಕಾ ಬೇಟಾ ಹಿಜ್ರಾ ಥಿ ಹಾ ಮೇಡಮ್ ವೈಸೆ ಇಚ್ ಬೋಲ್ತಾ ಸೋ ಉನ್ನೋ ಕೊಜ್ಜಾ ಕತೆ ಬೇಗಮ್ ಮರ್ ಗಯಿ ನೀ ತಬ್ ಹಿಮಾಲಯ ಕೋ ಗಯಿ ನೀ ಫಿರ್ ವಾಪಸ್ ಹಿ ನಹಿ ಆಯಿ ಔರ್ ವೋ ಕ್ಯಾ ಕರ್ತೆ ಥೆ ಭಯ್ಯಾ ಕುಚ್ ಔರ್ ಬತಾವ್ ಬೇಗಮ್ ಕ್ಯಾ ಥಿ ಕಹಾಂ ಸೇ ಆಯಿ ಥಿ वो नाचने वाली थी ना, एक्टर थी, एक्टर, खूबसूरत लड़की, लोगों को रख को धंधा करती, और उधर ना मैडम वो भी होता, वो क्या भैया, कैसा बोलता सो मैडम, नाच के होता सो मैडम, नाच के होता सो मैडम, बताओ भैया, वो ना मैडम, होमो होमो, as in to say that homosexuality would happen there in that Begum. So I just stop here and then. Any questions? Anything? No, I'm tired. I'm sorry. Well, it's not my argument. The actual person who argues that is Sunil. I only worked with him. I'll explain to whatever extent I understood him. I think you should, if you come to Rahi office, you can have a very long, happy conversation with him, because the moment you touch him with gender, he will go on. He'll be very happy to do that. I think, first, it shocked the hell out of me when he said gender should not be identity, and then I started like working with him and trying to understand that. So he was only talking in terms of course, the whole society is gendered, and the way society is gendered is because of the patriarchal needs. Because patriarchy wanted to control certain sections of the society for the convenience of a certain section of the society. So if you have to have that regulation and that control of certain sections, which includes Dalits, Adivasis, or whatever, and this whole Varna system and all those things, and women, and especially the sexuality of women, then it eventually was the most convenient way to gender everything. So you just remove that convenience and try to think of a space not gendered for some time. For example, we're all sitting here, we're all here. Okay, till now we have spoken quite a lot of gender here, but we've not made this space gendered. Have we? It's not gendered here, or we did not, or we have used all genders, or we have made it gender fluid. Maybe this space we have made it slightly gender fluid, maybe to a certain extent. But you know, think of a space where we don't have to base it on identities. That's what he is trying to propagate. I mean, like, I don't know what he does. He thinks now. No, one is that people whom we spoke to ask for confidentiality, which is exactly why we didn't bring Begum on stage. And we didn't also want to restrict the Begum's probable actual life. We don't know. So two reasons why we didn't bring Begum on stage. Actually, in the end, it's a lament by the lot of people. It's a lament.
where they're crying, saying how one sudden day the mahal got burnt and everything destroyed to ashes. And when it destroyed to ashes, there was nothing that could be done. Suddenly, overnight, the entire set of, I think, 300 families were living inside that compound had to be thrown out at that moment. And the unfortunate thing is that it doesn't get reported in the papers. But later, ever since this show has come up, this thing has come up, there are lots of people who are approaching us and are trying to give us more and more stories about Begum. But we are tired now because we can't continue anymore. I'm like, this is just a... So this, we don't want to really get into the investigation of what happened to Begum. And if somebody wants to really get into that detailed history of what really happened to that actual Begum, that actual Mahal and that actual people and all that, I think one should really take up that project. It is going to be super interesting. But then we were looking... So for us, why we approached Begum was not because of the woman or the Mahal or whatever, but because of the inclusive nature of that space. Because if you look at it, we were told by one of the sex workers saying that... She said something as simple as this, saying that now... I go to a place near a flyover where there is a burial ground, and I end up sleeping on many ashes, and I do sex work there, and then once it is done, she even in hot summer she wears socks, coat and everything, because she won't have time even to clean herself of the dust. So that was the woman who was trying to say that at one point of time we used to have this place where I needn't even rent a room to have sex, to take my clients and do sex work. I just need to get in and tell that giraki aaya hai, so they would just give me space and then I take the money and I go. And it did even change slightest design of that space or dynamics of that space. So this is something that we were thinking about. For us, that is the just imagine allowing your own home to a sex worker to use it for her client and then go. Which is crazy, right? So that is the height of inclusivity that this woman thought of. Yeah.
Can you talk about the ethics of archiving
and why did we even think of archives or oral histories was when people started coming to us and asking this kind of rubbish questions. In fact, one absolute funny thing was that French woman came to Sunil's house, and then Sunil is this person who is very welcoming of people, and then she came and she's like, Sunil, I want to make a film on you. So Sunil, already his face went types. And then she's like, I will start recording you from today midnight at 12 till tomorrow midnight at 12. He freaked out. I pee and shit like you. I pee and shit like others. I brush my teeth. I take a shower like every other person. Why do you want to make this kind of stupid documentary on me? Then she was like, no, it is audio visual of an oral history. And she went on with some heavy words. Sunil and I freaked out and what is going to happen to us? Then we said, okay, fine, no, we are not ready for this. We said, and then she challenged us, saying, if you do, what will you do? That's when we started thinking, and we actually did a Muguspeka. We actually did one project called Historical Tools of Recording Oral Histories of Queer and Trans Lives. And we recorded around, we did 24 videos. So we went to friends, we went to our own friends, and what we asked was, we didn't say, tell us coming out story. First of all, rule out coming out, so enough of coming out. We don't have to come out, yeah. Sick and tired of come out. What come out? If I ask you to come out, will you come out about your sexual love? Why will you do that? So don't ask me, no. Why should I? Not like I carry it, pinned it here that I'm saying, I'm homosexual. I'll not go around, no. I don't understand why that nonsense is needed. Never mind. Second thing is that rule out coming out stories. Or even if you're thinking of Dalit histories or any other marginalized histories, you don't have to pressurize them to focus their own marginalization and give that story based on that. Instead, and see, the second main problem with oral histories is that one is you ask for stories, two is that you don't let the marginalized person to critique or to analyze something, assuming that the person is not capable of that, which is the biggest pain that we face from the academics. To the extent that they will say, you just tell the story, we will do the analysis. I'm like, what? Are we not capable of analysis? What analysis are you going to do? We might not be trained academically, but we can do analysis of our own situations in our own ways. We don't need your academic tools to do that. So that's when we redefined our questions. So the questions that we asked was, while doing this thing, is you reflect on your life. Suppose I'm asking you, you reflect on your life. Tell us what you want to tell, thinking back, like thinking back from now, what you felt at that point of time, and what do you feel about it now? Just the change in that question, what a range of things we got. I mean, I clearly remember, I can definitely quote this person, she's my very close friend, and the video was also out. Living Smile Vidya, if you know, the theater person who is now in Switzerland. When we interviewed her, she was fantastic. So she was a MPhil fellow before transition in Kannada, sorry, not Kannada, Tamil literature, and linguistics was her favorite subject. And then after that, before going to applying to PhD, she went for transition, and she was in Bombay. And the post-transition, the first work that she was asked to is go and beg. Like, yeah, and the first MPhil studies, everything, she was like, you know, it hit at my face. My arms were not coming in the front to ask for money. And then she had to finally do it. And then she tells this very funny story. She says that because I was born in Arundhati, our caste, but because I was born male, I got the privilege of at least to get educated, primary education. If I had not passed, then I would have been one of those parakarmikas, safai karmacharis. But thankfully, I studied well, and so I continued education. I fought at home to continue education. So she says, thankfully, she says, I'm very happy I'm not a cis woman, I'm a trans woman. Otherwise, I would have missed education. You look at the analysis that she gives. Instead, if we had asked her come out and tell story, then she would have slapped her face. Now I write very slow. And now I want to do two things. Like I told you this, Vagina Man, Notes from a Vagina Man, that I want to make it a satire. But language is my big issue. I write only in Kannada. I hate English. I don't like English. I find very difficult to write in English. But there is another thing I really want to write in English, or a mix of English, Hindi, and Kannada, maybe. That is a different thing. It's my very personal journey of gender and voice and
my fascination for tawaifs and tumri music. So I want to kind of, I'm thinking that I'll start, because I've collected the histories, I can't say histories, the stories of all these tawaif women, and I'm kind of looking at voice mainly, in terms of, now somehow the stereotypical voice of a woman has become the squeaky type of voice, which was not so in the earlier times. Like when Begum Akhtar sang or Siddheshwari sang, gender was not so important. And then second is that Indian voices never thought of melody. And if you look at Mallikarjun Mansoor, and if you look at somebody like M.D. Ramanathan or Mallikarjun Mansoor, can you ever say they are melodious voice? The melody goes out of the window. And then what actually becomes very important in Indian music is more about the content rather than how it is presented. Exactly. So I want to kind of trace my gender journey through the voice. And I'm also excited that I have started the hormone therapy, and I've also started changing my practice to develop the male or maybe intermediary. I don't understand what is going to happen, but yeah, I've realized my pitch has come down. I don't sing in high pitch anymore. Or so that's the transition thing is. Maybe I'll just sing one fun song for you.
One fun song.
This is off on whatever. Huh. This is in Raag Alheya Bilawal. Have you
ni bull ba 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 black sheep.
It's like this.